Mishmar and Esther, we bow a lot. We bow at the beginning, we bow at the end, and then we bow right in the middle, at the bracha of Modim. The bracha of Modim is a slightly different bowing, but in order to understand how it's different, we have to understand what bowing looks like during the other brachos. So at the beginning and the end of Shemon Esrei, Chazal tell us in brachos on Lamed Dalet Amud Aleph, we should bow twice, in the bracha of Avos, and again twice in the bracha of Modim. The Baba Kama on Daf Tesvav Amud Aleph actually says at the bottom of the page that a person's spine will turn into a snake if they don't bow at Modim. Now, now's not the time to understand the depth of that Gemara, but we know that we want to be bowing during the bracha of Modim. Now, the Mishnah Berurah tells us that when we're bowing, we want to bow and stick our heads down, not too far, not past our waists. We're not acrobats per se, but we're going to put our heads down, you know, somewhere, I guess you call it between the strike zone, between our chests and our waists. And that's a good bowing. When we go down, we want to go down quickly as a sign of subservience to a Kaddish Baruch Hu. When we go up slowly. We don't want to leave the bowing motion between us and a Kaddish Baruch Hu. That's a personal interaction, if you will. And there's a discussion. When are we supposed to go down? When are we supposed to go up? The Kitta Shulchan Aruch, as well as Rav Yaakov Emden and his Siddur, and Rishova Sharsha Avoda, all say that we're supposed to go up before Shem Hashem, whether in a bracha or in the bracha Modim, whereas as the Mishnah Berurah and the Orchos Chaim say, we're supposed to do it at the bracha, at Shem Hashem, because Hashem is Zokiv Kfufim. Hashem stands people up. He straightens those who are crooked. And so we should be standing at Shem Hashem. Now, during ordinary brachot, we'll bend our knees at Baruch. And the Zohar says, you know, the lashon of Baruch, the lashon of Birkav, meaning knees, has some allusion to it. And so we want to bend our knees at Baruch and bow at Atta. And then straighten up either before or during at that Shem Hashem. However, when it comes to Modim, there's no Baruch, there's no Atta, so what are we supposed to do? We say Modim Anachnu Lach, and it's a machlokes whether we should just be bowing immediately or if we should bend our knees as well. The Arizal and Mishnah Berurah Paskins this way says that that bowing is supposed to be immediate. It's supposed to be different than the other bowing. It's supposed to bow right at Modim. However, the Aruch HaShulchan, the Chai Odom, Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, and the Ben Ish Chai all say that it should be a normal bowing with bending your knees and then bowing, but everyone would agree that you don't do it in two different words. Everyone says that we bow at that first word of Modim, because the bowing of Modim is a special bowing of thanks, and we want to do it differently. We want to do it special. Now, there's beautiful piece in the Aruch HaShulchan in Kuf Chaf Aleph, Simon Aleph. Just take a look just to get an idea there about some of the hints, the Ramazim, the beautiful language that's built into this bracha for a little bit more. Have a wonderful day.